these radios.
I'm going to continue to broadcast.
You don't have to listen to them. You just have to basically collect them.
You should be able to pick up the signal right across the valley.
The point of this trophy is to only find the radios before you do anything else in the game. All of the radios. There are 24 of them. Anyway, as I was saying, I am going to use a guide. No, don't do that. Hit the X and go on, because if you pay attention to the story, yes, it would. Yeah, if you had to sit and listen to them, that's absolutely correct. You don't want to use any of the motion controls. You don't want to follow any of the story beats. You want to ignore all of these things and just find all of the radios. All of the radios that are orange and white. And you can't interact in any other way. Nope, I gotta ignore that. Nope, I gotta ignore that thing coming up. Stop following me, I'm ignoring you. This is why I did not try. No. This is why I did not try to get this. The only thing that you can do, to get this trophy. I am running. So fuck, this is running in the game. I'm holding down R2, and that's as fast as you can go. Hit X. The X button.
Reminds me of high school.
Or the cross button. And you have to ignore everything else. Now, as I said before, I'm using a guide. It's on PlayStationTrophies.org. The trophies in this game, as I said, are insane. And what you really need to do is use a trophy guide. Because if you don't, you're never going to be able to platinum this game. And it does have a platinum trophy. Ugh. Sorry, hold on a second. One of my cats is eating her own hair, and, you know, that just... I mean, she's going to be throwing up any minute. Okay. So, I'm at PlayStationTrophies.org. Sebe, 4211, whose location is Merca, is the one who has provided the text for finding these trophies. So, I am following that guide as I do this. There are 24 radios that you have to find. Oh, wait, did I go? What did I? Not that one. Oh, wait, I hear it. Crap. Maybe it's around here. Ah, yeah, there it is. And now I'm running again. I'm running!
I keep looking, but it makes no sense.
Yeah, I know it doesn't make any sense.
The area we picked the pattern up from can no...
Okay, that was radio number 3. Number 4, go to the Yacht and Spin Central Park. Nearby are house number 4 and number 6. Of course, they're not numbered, so I don't know why. But this is this person's... Walk down the path between them until you go to the left of to the backyard. Number six, walk to the... Oh, God,
hello,
I'm never getting this trophy, am I?
See me as an outsider here as well.
I see you as an outsider as well, as well.
I understand it's difficult. That's all I'm saying.
Now, just so you know, I can't get this trophy now, because if I do, it will negate the trophy that I'm trying to get for the radios. But you see that witch's hat? If you just go and stand on that for 2 minutes, you get a trophy. It might have fleas, Georgie.
I wish the council would clean them up.
Well, apparently they're saying it's a flu epidemic, and I gather they'll be closing the roads.
No, you cannot jump. No. The game was created very specifically for a very specific experience.
Well, thanks, but I have word with Neil, see what he thinks.
And
Benjamin, for God's sake, leave it alone.
GTA, it is not. It's a very slow game that washes over you, with story elements, and it's a brilliant game, but it's... yes, well, you can, as I said, to get a trophy, you stand on the witch's hat, but... Thank you, Ben, yes. The trophies were meant to break that experience. Yeah, so as a trophy hunt, which is what this is, you're not going to get the game. No, but if you wanted to ride a bike as a goat, you could do that in that other game that I streamed. When you're a goat. Goat Simulator. What's the name of that game? Oh yeah, Goat Simulator. Okay. Oh, hold on a second. Go to the yacht and sign in Central Park. Okay, well, this has got to be Central Park. So, where's the yacht and sign here? Okay, now I'm running again. Running. No, that's a map. I don't want to look at that. If you look at that map, because there's another trophy for maps. And my fear is if I look at that, I will negate this trophy that I'm trying to find. So... I need to... Oh, crap. Anyway... Ooh, that was nice. Did you see that? That was actually very well animated. The dragonfly. Okay. Go to the yacht and sign. Oh, for frack's sake. This is clearly Central Park, right? Am I insane? No. Well, yes, but no. Yeah, but no. Nah, it's the Potters. The Potterses. Yay, Ravens! Okay. Okay. I need to find... Oh, crikey. Okay, here we are. Alright, I went through here. This is Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. I'm not sure why it didn't come out on the bottom of the screen like it was supposed to. It doesn't make any sense. Right, the map and the bulletin board. But what I'm looking for is the Yachten sign. The one that says Yachten. And as I recall, and by the way, I am running now. Oh, maybe I'm just really tired. No! Don't do that! Not looking for this trophy. There's a sign for Yachten over here. No, I'm not answering your phone. See, here's the Otten sign. You can't run faster. Welcome to Yachtin. Okay. Supposed to walk down the path between two houses. Well, that doesn't make any damn sense. Okay, so I'm using a trophy. List guide that I myself have not vetted. However, it is on. You can't drive. There is no driving. You can't do that. Yeah, the voice acting is unbelievable. It's really unbelievable. It's crazy. Oh, no. Well, I'm assuming this is Central Park. Yachtin's Central Park. Okay, well. Oh, boy. You know, let me explain. Here's my horror. I all but, I all but platinumed the original PS3 Infamous. The reason that I did not was because I literally have one shard that I never found. No, there's no radio in there. You suck! Nope, can't go in there. There was one shard that I couldn't find. And the problem is that you don't know where they all are, and you can't, you know, it was this, I have spent hours. Oh, yeah, I have that one too. I know, damn shards. And because I could not, and you know, I did the whole thing where I played it through. Once is good, once is evil. I mean, I love that game. No, 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 no. I am not going to do that. Well. All right, let's go around here and see if I can find this radio over here. By the way, this is me running. Slow, you're not kidding. But, no! Okay. There is a greenhouse. I think this one might have a radio in it. But this is a crazy trophy. Whee! This is a crazy trophy. But if you want to platinum it, you have to do this. Find all the radios before doing anything else. And, oh, crap. This always reminds me of the TV movie It. Like where you go through here and then Tim Curry will be on the other side to kill you. Ah! Oh, no, he's not. There's supposed to be a house here with a... with a greenhouse in the back, and that greenhouse has a radio in it. Right over a hedge. I didn't know I could do that. Glitch! Tweet it! That's a weird noise. Supposed to be a path between two houses. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, there's a path between two houses. And a greenhouse. Ooh! Ah, here we are. This is what I was looking for.
The magnetic field is causing disruptions to phone signals and
you can tell.
There are voices on the line.
As you play, and this is one of the great things about this game, is that it doesn't prompt you as to what to do. If you walk up to something, it doesn't say, do this, push this button. You have to figure that out on your own. Okay, look directly at the Robert Graves auto repair sign. Wait. Okay, well, that's... it doesn't say to go all the way down there, though. Hold that thought. Okay, I've done this one. I can't see the sign from this backyard. Okay. All right. Yeah, I don't know what kind of shoes. I would assume... oh, there it is. Okay. Look at the auto repair sign. Dual 180. Walk down the path to the right of the house and enter the mobile home. Ooh. Now, what's weird about that is... stop bothering me! I'm not here for you. I'm here for the radios. By the way, I'm still running. What I think is kind of funny is that I think that the Chinese room knew that they had to put trophies in the game, and this game is not a trophy collector kind of game. I mean, on its own. So, I have a feeling that what they did was, this is sort of a screw you. We'll even make it a platinum. And, wait, now is that the sign or is that the sign? Oh, God. Okay. Well. Now, I've already been back there, and I know there's no mobile home there. So that can't be it. Ah! I see a mobile home. Eureka! Oh, and I hear it, too. Yeah, shut up. Shut up, Kate. I don't have time for your little shit.
I may not understand it yet, but it wasn't an accident.
Okay, so. Near the stars at night, there are three roads, left, middle, and right. Go down the left road until you see the Badger's Loft sign. Well, yo, are you trolling? Stars at night. Stars at night. That's a pub that's over here, I think. No. You cannot open up a map. You can find a map. You can find maps. They're all around. But that's a different... Literally, that is a different, trophy. And since this one is do this before anything else, looking at a map might even negate what you're doing here. No, that's not it. It's a room for rent sign. I'm running. You know, I should have paid more attention to, the name of this pub over here. But I didn't. No, you don't want to start all over. And you don't want to accidentally screw yourself in the middle of looking for these things. Okay, here's the stars at night. Okay, and the guide says, look directly, no. Near the stars at night, there are three roads, left, middle, and right. Go down the left road until you see the Badger's Loft sign. Okay, here's the stars at night. Oh, right, there's middle. Here we go. We're going to go this way until we see the Badger's Loft sign. I really love this game. Clearly, I gave it a 10. Badger's Loft. Okay, there's Badger's Loft. Thank you, Mubat. The house behind that sign... head through the front gate and go around the house to the right into the backyard. The radio is on a tree stump next to a wheelbarrow. That's quite specific. Oh, yeah. Because there are audio clues. You can hear it. Wheelbarrow? Tree stump. Look at that.
Electrical failures all over Tower 6.
Yeah, of course there are.
Flowing like liquid. What sense of purpose is...
Ooh. My controller vibrates every time I do that. Okay.
Okay. Oh, where is that? This, there are six in Yachtin, and that was... That doesn't make any sense. Oh, right, because of the observatory. From the previous radio, head through the gate at the back of the backyard, then across the road and through another gate into a large open field. Go towards the tractor. There's a radio on a barrel near the tractor. So, from the previous radio, which I just left because I'm a moron. Go out the gate at the back, which would be this one. While getting this, oh, here we are. While getting this trophy, the only thing you can do is click X on the radios and click X on, yeah, I got you.
I've been recording the pattern for 3 hours and so far have accumulated over...
Click X on any gate you need to get through, and that's all you can do. Okay. So, that was all for Yachtin. Now we need Tipworth Forest.
Which means I just have to walk there. I hope it's this way. I'm sure it is. If anybody saw the video that I posted in my review, there's the church where that video takes place. Okay, let's go this way. Looks like it's... No, can't go that way. Okay. Shepherd's Walk. That's not a thing, is it? No.
It doesn't even reach the back fence, silly little bugger.
Well, loaves and fishes we can manage.
Father Jeremy, might I have a word?
Mrs. Boyles, of course.
I'll see you back at Charlie's.
Oh my. I've just come back here. That's fine. The forest is right in front of me over there. By the way, I'm running. We're running and we're running. You know, life is strange. That game has a mode that you can play where you're just hunting for trophies. And it doesn't change your game saves. Nothing you do will impact the way that you played the game. And you can just go hunt for trophies. This game desperately needs that. It really does. No, Wendy, I don't care about you, Wendy. I'm not caring. Oh, watch the light move. Not that little light, the actual sunlight. It's pretty amazing. You were asking about maps. There's one of them. I daren't go near it. I know. Slow down, you move too fast. You gotta make the moment last, just. Ooh, foresty. Ugh, the sound in this game is just incredible. Incredible. Stay alive! Damn it! Oh, no, wait. It's unbreakable. Now. Nope. Yes, I am traveling through time. No. No.
Terry called this morning.
Ah!
He said there was a problem with Arvin. He said he couldn't
get back,
so I said I'd come round and take a look.
There's a lot of death.
This game could really use that. Mode whereby you just hunt for trophies. Because then maybe I could actually run. So I'm not, you know, power walking like an 80-year-old through a mall. Okay. Yachton Road.
Phone call from Steven.
Oh, shut up.
He wants to shut down.
Now, here's the problem.
Something about instances across the valley.
Sure, you're gonna have
There's
to hear that.
Intermittent electrostatic discharges radiating out of Tower 6. All of the electrics on the main gate are blown. I'll find time to take a look once the data stream begins to calm down here.
Oh my. I have a feeling. Oh god, I don't want to go all the way back there. But, what the frack?
Thank you.
I remember this weird little playground area. So frisbee. No. By the way, I know I am now in the completely wrong place to follow this guide. I don't even know what area I'm in now. Thanks a lot. But, it's alright. Once I do figure that out. Oh, I think the train is up there, right? There's another thing, there's another trophy called Train Spotting, where you look at all the numbers on the trains. So you would need to come here for that, but is there a radio up there? That's what I want to see. I don't hear a radio. No, there's no radio here. All right. Let's go down over here. Because we can. So weird because there's no radio over there. When I played this game all the way through before, it seemed like everywhere you went, you ran into another sign that told you you were in a different section of the county, and bees, lots and lots. Bees. I hear a radio. I see a radio!
There's something in the observatory with me.
There's something in the air that night. The stars are bright. Oh, yeah! Oh, dude. Oh, yes. We bought our Star Wars tickets.
Come on, you stupid bastard.
A couple of weeks ago. And, let's go in here and see if there's a radio.
Stephen?
We are... The best seats we could get were,
Stephen, at... are you here? It's your mother. Answer me.
Shut up, lady.
Steven!
That's another trophy in this game. Where you play only Steven's sections of the game.
What have you done, Steven?
Feck off.
Oh, Kate.
There must be a logic to the pattern.
Well, I'm in northern New Jersey in New York City, so there are like
it's alive.
Tons of explanation. Of cinemas and stuff and places to go. But
Stephen, where is Kate? Are you here?
So we were lucky and we're going but we still have to go at like 9:45 in the evening. There are a lot of story elements here. Look at that crap. Oh, wow. And L.A. sold out. Okay, go through that way. Ben, you're going to, what, you're going to all six movies? Isn't that what you said before? That's insane. And, three and a half of them I pretty much despise. I saw the first one the summer it came out. I was in junior high school. I was like, it was 1977. I was 13 going on 14. And, oh, wow. You know, I would wait. All seven starts Thursday morning at 3 a.m. Wow, dude, that is hardcore. Hardcore. And, I would not enjoy that because I am too old and I would be asleep through at least 6 hours of that madness. The prequels, are, I hate them. Oh, that's cool. 7 o'clock Thursday night. God, that's insane. No, I would not do that. I wouldn't even do that in my own house where I could pause and get up and go poop and come back. But yeah, so I saw the first one like 7 or 8 times at the cinema. And then Empire Strikes Back, I think I saw 9 times. By the time it came out, I was driving. So I went to the 70mm theater, that just this gigantic place, and saw it on a screen so big you had to turn your head both ways. Back in, you know, 1980, that was not common. And I still remember my reaction with the Luke thing. Oh my god. In Empire Strikes Back, I was like, what? I lost my frickin' mind. Oh my god. I think they even cried. Okay, I hear another one. And then when the next one came out, and Leia said to Luke, oh, I've always known we were siblings. Get out of my way. Let me through here. Oh no. Really? I was like, okay, that's a lie. Oh, you would have been 4. You bastard. I'm gonna find another way through there to get to that. Oh, okay, I know where I'm going now. I remember this part. This area. So... So, yeah, because I'd waited years for Luke to divulge to Leia that, you know, they were siblings and the Vader connection and all of that. And she's like, I've known all along. I was like, okay, you just destroyed this completely. Because there was clearly drama about to happen. By the way, have you noticed there have been no loading screens this entire time? Which is nice. And the way the sun and the clouds play across the environment is pretty freaking great. Well, I did not see those in the theater, but my husband got them for me for Christmas last year. So I own them all on Blu-ray. I love the Lord of the Rings uncut. Look at that. I had to walk all the way around because this gate wouldn't open all the way.
All the power spiked with the last discharge and then...
Oh, shut up, Kate.
And I could see the Aurora dancing around Tower 6.
So, yeah, so as I said, I saw the first one like 7 or 8 times in the cinema because there was no home video option at all. And then I saw the next one about 9 times, because I liked it more, so I had to see it at least one more time than the other one. And then Return of the Jedi I saw once. So I went from being, you know, I was like an abused spouse at that point. Oh my God, how dare you lie to me? And then I saw each of the prequels one time. Because you gotta go. I mean, come on. Star Wars, you gotta go. And see how he's bastardizing his own product at that point. The Hobbit, I saw the first film and then stopped. And I honestly don't even remember it. If you want to see a good Hobbit movie, watch, get your hands on a DVD of the animated one from the 70s that was on television. It's an actual normal human length. It tells the whole story. It's very well acted. It's just, it's great. It's so much fun. This crap that they did, turning it into several films and all the rest of that, and I think they added some of the Silmarillion in there as well. It's just stupid. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Okay. Yeah, no, there's a motion thing over there. That's not it. Oh, yeah, there is. I almost want to say that it was... I think it's Rankin Bass. Go to Google and Google Hobbit Animated TV, or however you do your searches. And you should find it there. I own it on DVD. When it came out, and I was a kid, and there's another map, just so you're aware. When it came out and I was a kid, I watched it, and then I bought the record on vinyl. Oh, it won't let me get through. Dang it! Yeah, if you can't tell, I've left the guide that I have behind at this point, because... I am! I have been holding my damn finger down on this R2 button the whole time. And I am running. Do you want to see how fast it normally is? I'm taking my finger off the button. I don't know if you can tell the difference or not. Wait, let me speed up now. Ooh. Amazing. I do need to get a rubber band.
Hi! I want a word with you.
Jeez, what the bloody hell are you doing?
What the bloody hell are you doing? Nope, don't pay any attention to the man behind the curtain. You're looking for radios. Oh, God. I'm never going to platinum this. Okay. Okay. Let's get the bloody hell out of here. Oh, I finally did see Tusk. The Kevin Smith movie. Well, that's a weird... Weird, weird movie. But it has some really great and fun performances in it. I enjoyed it. I didn't buy it. I borrowed it from my brother-in-law. You? You? Ooh. I hear a radio. Ha-ha!
The radio telescope in Tower 6 is burned out.
Yeah, of course
background
it is.
Background radiation
I think there might be one over here as well. Yeah, I was correct. Well remembered, Keith. Why, thank you, Keith. You have to go upstairs, then. And you probably have to go through the outside. Yeah, there it is. It's true.
I hung up on Stephen. He doesn't understand. Even if he were here to experience it directly, I'm still not sure he would.
Of course, the difference is that this game is just a little over 6 gigs, and even though it's actually open world for the most part, because clearly you can see what I'm doing. I'm going wherever I want to go. The problem is that Fallout 4 is gigantic. I mean, it's huge, and it has so much happening under the hood, as they say, that, not like this one. This one is, like, it's simpler, so. I'm probably going nowhere over here. Gonna let me climb up here? No. It's not. Yeah, The Witcher 3 is beautiful. And I have not played that much of it. GTA 5 is also good. It's just that it's, I think the GTA games are maybe not my cup of tea all that much. I mean, I own it. I bought it. And I bought all the stuff, and I've played it. But I haven't played it enough, I think. Because there's just so much to play. I mean, so many games. And when you're...
Wade called me in about 6 weeks after.
When you're also doing, you know, stuff for a website, and... And you have other things that you have to do. I'm speaking of which, I gotta check and see if I got a game code from Glenn. Forgot about that until just now. Yeah, you're right. It has been a very good game year for games. You speak the truth. Boy, the score for this game is pretty. Okay. There's something I'm not sure of. I don't know if you have to do this all in one go, or if you can stop playing and come back to it. Wait. I hear a radio. And there it is. Now, see that book? There's another thing where you have to find all the books.
Under the microscope, you could see how the light was following the cellular structure of its wings. The neural simplicity of the insects seems to prevent a full-blown infestation.
Oh, I absolutely believe they did that, Ben. Absolutely believe they did that, and that was good. But as I said, they could always have put an option to play a mode where you can run these without going so slowly. I mean, clearly what you want to do is, in the case of this game, is play it first. And then maybe if you want to collect the trophy, more trophies, you can do that. There's one that's called Completionist. Oh, that's bad. That would be good, yeah. There is a trophy that you get called Completionist where you have to literally click on every microwave. You have to click on every phone, whether it's ringing or not, whether it looks like you can interact with it or not. You have to. It's just insane. I agree, absolutely. That would make sense. Total sense, and that would be smart. So you can't run until after you've played the game through to completion. That's very smart!
I messed up, Frank, but I've done my time. They shouldn't keep on punishing me.
Some folk won't let go, Lisa, and they've got nothing better to do than to poke their noses into other people's business.
Ugh, the voice acting in this game is just so unbelievable. I know there's a map up here. See? I just remember that from having played it before. I hear a thingy. No, but... No, that's a phone ringing. A gigantic 4-pound cell phone. Pretty leaves. I think when I get to the end of this, I'm going to be inside the church. I think... Could be completely wrong. This game for trophies is just... it won't let me go that way because I don't have that story element yet. Oh, great. Oh, great. The last thing you want to do is find a dead end when you're hunting for trophies in this game. Lordy, lordy, lordy. No, it's the 80s, Ben. It's like, I think it might actually be 1984. It's 84 or 85. I mean, they've said so. And you can tell because of the cell phones that you find in cars and things. Those giant cell phones. Plus, the fact that they said so. Wow. 2015, the 80s looked like the 50s. Well, that's not necessarily true. The thing is that because we're in a rural area here, and because there are no pop culture references in the game, it's more difficult to actually kind of... Now, wait. I've been here, right? That's where I found that other one. Okay, we're going this way. Yeah, a lot of these structures are, of course, because we're talking about rural England. much older than, you know, the 50s. So it's trying to actually pin an exact time period on it is kind of difficult. Until you get into some of the houses, I haven't gone into a lot of the homes and paid any attention, you know, and shown around inside them or looked inside cars. But, yeah, I mean, if you look at the cars that I've passed by, you'll see that they're 80s-ish. I don't think there's really a reason it couldn't have been set in the 50s. Oh, we're coming up on a car now. Let's have a look.
There you go.
Oh, thanks, Frank. Let's get it out of the way. I don't know what happened. It just died on me.
Give it another go.
Because it's a Pinto or something. Sorry, not sorry. I wish I lived in one of these houses.
Robert's taken the other car into town.
I would like nothing better. And Carlos agrees with me on this, than to actually live inside the Vicar of Dibley. Oh, wait a minute. Not her. I mean the show. Gremlin Hatchback, thank you very much. Oh my, those were all over. Okay, now we're at the holiday camp. And, one of the things that you can do at the holiday camp... And there's a ringing phone. There's another trophy that you get up here at the holiday camp. Oh, the music's so loud. Hold on. Okay. Regardless of the ringing, you get a trophy for going into one of these telephone booths, closing the door behind you, and staying there for 3 minutes. I didn't make it up. That's an actual trophy that I will not be getting now, because before I do anything else, I have to find all the radios. There's also a trophy for trying to get into, for jiggling the handle on every single caravan door up here at the holiday, camp area. Yeah, it's true. Probably the most complicated trophy, when you come to the end of it, is... Oh, 10 minutes gets you Passive Observer. I got that right at the very beginning of the stream. As soon as I hit Start Broadcast, I popped that trophy. Because I had gone away from the game for a few minutes and left my controller alone. Yeah, the hardest one is you go straight to Steven, the beginning of his story, and you play only through his story. Then, when you get to right before you go in the bunker, you stop, make sure that the game has auto-saved by watching the screen to make sure it shows that it's auto-saved, and then... You download that save onto, you have to quit the game and download the save onto a USB drive so that you don't have to redo all of that, because the next thing you do is start there and go into the bunker. And because you haven't played any other story elements, the game is completely open-ended, actually, which is what they call that trophy, open-ended. Can you believe that? They made a trophy. Most of these trophies are made so that you don't play the game. Like this Easter egg hunt I'm on. Well, that is a pretty, pretty game. Well, I don't know how many how many radios I've found so far, but I am going to end the stream here. I only stream for about an hour, and I try to get as far as I can in whatever I'm doing, but, you know, what I will do is, if I get to a section, what I'm going to try to do is platinum the game. So when I get to just about having it platinumed, I'll stream myself popping the platinum trophy. Although, you won't be able to tell that that's platinum. Yeah, you can always look at my trophy list. And, yeah, because I got all the time in the world to keep doing this. Okay. Well, thank you for coming around. You can find me on Twitter at Keith, P as in Peter, Dunn. And PS Nation is at PS Nation. And you can find Josh's stream. Will you get Firewatch? You know, honestly, I'm not really sure. My head's been up my own ass this week, for one thing. And, oh, no, that's a garbage can. Thought maybe it was another radio. Okay, well, I have enjoyed streaming this for you and yakking away, and I've enjoyed talking to you guys. And I will see you next Sunday for TGI Sunday with Keith Dunn Fernandez. Now, you can join my community, which is on PS4. It's one of the communities, and you can also feel free to go on the forums. There is one. Yeah, please keep coming back. There's one thread now, so if you watch that thread, you'll get notifications when it gets changed. What I do every week is I put up three games for community members to vote on which one they want to see me stream, or you can write in, and that's absolutely copacetic. I'm not particular. I do this for you guys, so. All right. Thank you all very much. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Thank you, Ben. Oh, Ben. Moobot says you can't put a link. That's too funny. No links allowed, CN Palmer. Warning. Oh, my God. That's hilarious. Okay, so, but yeah, go on the forums. Thank you for coming around today, Ben, and yeah. Ben! Oh no! It's Torgo's Benhammer. All right. Thanks again, everybody.